What's going on, guys? It's Omniarch, and today I'm bringing you a brand new video where we're going to be talking about whether or not it's worth it to invest in Minamoto in Rise of Kingdoms. Now, Minamoto has been a topic of discussion for a few weeks now amongst other content creators for Rise of Kingdoms, as well as for me personally, you know, people who are watching my newest videos, they're typically new to the game, so they have a lot of questions about commanders, and one of the more popular questions is Minamoto. People are asking me, is he good? Is he worth investing in? Should I buy him, or did I mess him up now that I already paid for him? And on top of that, this is also something that some of my Alliance members have actually been talking about recently, just kind of, you know, inside conversation, like, hey, do you think it's worth it? So I wanted to make this video and give my two cents because I know other content creators have talked about this, but I wanted to just throw in my opinion. So if you guys don't know, Minamoto can only be obtained by purchasing these special privilege chests in the VIP tab, and that's the only way to get him. You can't convert universal sculptures into Minamoto. That's the only way. And what that means is that the only way to get him is to just straight up buy him with money. Like, you just have to spend money to get him. You have to spend money, or at least spend gems, to get to VIP 9 if you want to max him. But to get him directly, you need to just buy these chests for dollars. And you can see here, I haven't even maxed him. So that should give you a little bit of an idea where this video is going. But it doesn't paint the whole picture, so don't click off. So let's take a look at Minamoto really quickly. Minamoto is a legendary commander, obviously. He is interested in the cavalry units type, and he also can do peacekeeping, and he also has the skill tree, which is really interesting. So that's what we're looking at, right? We're looking at a legendary cavalry commander. And so in order to decide whether or not he's worth investing in, we first have to look at his skills, and then we have to look at the other options for cavalry units, right? What other commanders could we use if we don't have Minamoto? So the first thing we have to look at is our skills. So we'll quickly go through this. So this first skill deals direct damage factor of 1400 to the target and has a 50% chance to deal an additional damage factor of 600 to the target each second for 2 seconds. So that's, he has a chance of doing an additional 1200 damage, which total is 2600 damage, which makes this skill one of the strongest skill attacks, direct damage single target attacks in the game. I think there's only one other skill attack that's better, and that might be Edward. Does he have a better skill? No, he doesn't. So yeah, it's hard to say. I mean, he has one of the best, if not the best, from what I know, direct damage skill attacks, if he can get this second factor to go off consistently. And that means his expertise would most likely have to be unlocked, because what you could see is the changes, it goes from 50 to 75. So right away, I mean, for him to be a season one veteran of this game and still have one of the highest, if not the highest, single target skill damage skills in the game is impressive, right? That's impressive. That's not something that you can ignore. The second skill is where we start to fall off a little bit, because if you look, it says you can get up to 20% cavalry attack bonus and 10% cavalry march speed, which is good, right? 20% boost to attack is nice. If you look at Bybars, his second skill also gives your cavalry a 20% boost in attack. So, you know, Minamoto is a little bit better because you do get march speed with that, which is good. I mean, he is legendary, so it should be better, right? It should be better. And march speed is useful, right? March speed is very useful to get away from enemies that are stronger than you, and also to get to help your allies faster, get to flag building faster, just move around the map quicker, right? That's useful to have. So march speed, even though it doesn't increase your damage or survivability or anything like that directly, it is still incredibly useful. So he is a bit better than Bybars in that way, and thus is better than the epics in this tier. However, if we look at Cao Cao, who is another, he's another season one cavalry legendary veteran. His version of this skill gives you 30% attack bonus and 10% march speed. So if you're comparing him to other legendary cavalry commanders, he falls a little bit short. So let's keep moving on. Let's look at his third skill. Increases damage dealt to barbarians by troops led by this commander by up to 50% if it's maxed. Now, this is where we no longer are doing any sort of help to our PvP game, right? This doesn't affect PvP at all. This is only good for killing barbs. Minamoto is good at taking down barbarian forts because he has that peacekeeping tree, but is it worth spending $270 to $300 to max Minamoto just to use him to attack barb forts? Like, probably not, right? Like, for most people, that would not be something worth spending $300 on. So let's move on to the next skill. Troops' normal attacks have a 10% chance to increase damage taken by the target by 15% for the next 3 seconds. That's for me, but it goes up to 30. Can only trigger once every 5 seconds, so there's a cooldown. So you can't just like somehow glass cannon, get super lucky, and just have insane spiky DPS. But regardless, pretty good, right? You have a 10% chance of them taking 30% more damage, which if that's just so coincides with this skill right here, they're going to be taking 30% more damage from that massive skill attack. So could, if that's timed properly, it could do a ton of extra damage. And then again, we already talked about the expertise. So that's Minamoto, right? We've already talked about his skills, we've talked about his talents, we've talked about how you get him. And we've talked about how to max him, it costs anywhere from $280 to $300, somewhere in that ballpark. I didn't do the math exactly. So first I want to talk about Minamoto as an expertise commander, and then I want to talk about Minamoto as a 5-5-1-1 commander, which is another option. So let's start with talking about expertise Minamoto, right? If you expertise him, then I would have to say he's probably in the late game the worst cavalry legendary, because as time goes on, Minamoto gets less useful. And the reason for that is because other people are getting more legendaries, which makes his legendary status being a novelty at the beginning of the game decrease over time. Plus, I think he just falls a little bit short, right? We've already talked about Cao Cao, how this skill is outpaces him with this skill. I also think Cao Cao, while he does lack the damage with that first skill attack, he does reduce their attack by 40% and their march speed. Plus, he has some healing. Plus, his expertise is incredible because it gives you an extra 25% cav attack. So I think Cao Cao is a little bit better. And then it only gets worse from there because the other commanders that are released afterwards, like Genghis Khan, who's a great pairing for Cao Cao, but also I think is a little bit better than Cao Cao, and Saladin, which is the same boat, right? These commanders come out later and are even better. And, you know, whether or not other content creators want to agree with me or not, there's clearly power creep in this game, right? The commanders are getting better over time, obviously. And then so these are the 120 day commanders. Once you hit the 240 day commanders, you see Attila and Takeda. Now, Attila and Takeda's usefulness in the open field is probably comparable to some of the other commanders we've talked about, maybe a little bit better. But they are, in terms of rallying, they are tier zero, like game changing meta, right? Like right now, at the time of recording this, Attila Takeda is the best combo to rallying cities, flags, forts, anything, right? So you can't even compare Minamoto to them because of how insanely good they are at that one task. They're super useful for that task. So with that being said, ultimately, Minamoto's usefulness is going to go down over time. However, I do think Minamoto, especially as expertise, is better than all of the other epic commanders that are focused on cavalry. So at that point, it gets interesting, right? Because if you expertise Minamoto, you can expect your investment to lose value over time. And again, he's still a good commander, right? But he's not the best, and in fact, he is probably the worst in the legendary tier. Now, again, that's kind of, it's not exactly comparing apples to apples because he's much easier to get, you just buy him, and it takes a lot of time to actually get a fully expertised legendary commander. So by the time 240 days passes and you finally unlock Attila, right, for example, if you're lucky enough to get him, then you still have, from that point, have to expertise him. So he'll still be way behind. So it's interesting, right? If you are spending an insane amount of money on this game and your kingdom is really old and somehow you never invested in Minamoto, then just ignore him, right? Just ignore him. But I don't think that's the case. So let's talk about Minamoto early game, right? Because we just talked about over time he's going to lose value. Early game, it's a different story. If your kingdom is less than 6 months old, you're going to see Minamoto everywhere. Because as I said before, it's very hard to get legendary commander sculptures. It's hard to summon them from gold keys. It's hard to get them from events because other people are competing for them. So legendary commander sculptures are rare. So for the first few months, Minamoto is going to be the only expertised legendary commander that people have, which is immediately going to make him better than Cao Cao, because if Cao Cao is not maxed, it's hard to compare them. Same thing with the epics. At the beginning of the game, you're not even going to have maxed epics. So immediately you have a massive, massive leg up on your competition. So if you're playing this, if you just got this game, and you're considering spending a decent amount of money, meaning over $300, then I would consider maxing Minamoto, right? Because again, you're gonna have a massive leg up in your competition, which is gonna give you huge advantages early game, and it will set you up for success in the future. And on top of that, later down the line, if you're still playing the game, he'll still be a legendary commander that you have expertise, and he's not terrible, right? Even though he's technically the worst in that category, we're comparing him to commanders that are insanely hard to get for most people. So, you know, comparing him to a commander that you're never realistically going to get anyway, is that even useful? I don't know. So early game, if you are looking to spend money on this game, and you're going to be spending a few hundred, you don't mind spending that money on a mobile game, which I wouldn't advise spending that much money, especially if you can't afford it. Please don't spend what you can't afford on any mobile game or any game in general. But in the early game, if you're going to spend a decent amount of money on this game, it's worth maxing Minamoto because you'll have a massive advantage early game and he'll still have some value late game. Let's say you only have $300 to spend on this game, right? In the event that you think Rise of Kingdoms is worth $300 and that's all you're going to spend, should you buy Minamoto? I would say no. I would say it's not worth maxing Minamoto because there's just so many other opportunities for you to spend money and get more value. And because you know Minamoto is going to go down in value later on anyway, it's probably not best to expertise Minamoto if you're only going to spend $300 over the course of your Rise of Kingdoms career. So with that out of the way, I've kind of outlined in what scenarios I would recommend expertising him, and it really comes down to your spending habits and the age of your kingdom. Let's talk about 5-5-1-1 Minamoto for a second, right? Because I kind of have a slightly buffed version of that. I was unlucky enough to get most of my skills landing in this third one as opposed to this fourth one, which would have helped me a bit more with the PvP aspect of my Minamoto, but you can't win them all. Let's talk about 5-5-1-1 Minamoto, because I'm pretty sure you can get 5-5-1-1 for about $30, maybe a little bit more, depending on tax and whatever. If you look at I'm pretty sure you need 200 sculptures to get Minamoto to 5-5-1-1 because you need the first 10 summon him, and then you need 190 more, I believe, to fully get him, I think. So with that being said, you can buy VIP packs 1-7 except for 6, and I think you'll have him 5-5-1-1. Do the math before you make those purchases. I'm not exactly 100% confident on that. But regardless, you can get 5-5-1-1 Minamoto for a price that is way easier to swallow than $300, right? We're talking about a tenth of the price for, I would say, 65-75% of his value, maybe 70% of his value. I think a lot of his value is found in these first two skills, right? This third one, we already said, is only useful for barbs, which is not why you're spending money. You're spending money because you want to beat other players with him. And this fourth skill, you know, if you get it to one, you'll have a 10% chance of them taking 10% more damage. That's pretty good to me. I would say that makes him on par with the other epic commanders, maybe slightly better, because just because this first skill is just so powerful, I think he is slightly better than all the other epic cavalry commanders at 5511. And you know, maybe players can do some testing and you can prove me wrong or whatever. but you know, I think a 5511 Minamoto is worth getting if you're okay with spending 30-35 bucks on one commander. With that being said, you know, you have to do it right. You have to buy Minamoto, get this first skill to 5, take him to 2 stars and no further, right? Stop him at 2 stars, get this second skill to 5, and then get him, and then level him up to whatever. And if you do that, I would just keep him at 5511, keep him like a 4-star commander, keep him level 20 or 30 or whatever you could do, and just keep him as a secondary. Keep him as a secondary to like Pelagius or something. Or if you're spending a lot of money in this game in other areas, maybe you can get your hands on Cao Cao or maybe even Genghis Khan later down the line. I don't know. That's what I did. I ended up getting a bunch of legendary commander sculptures and just putting them all into Cao Cao for a while, getting him from the daily chests, getting him from gold keys, and eventually I maxed him, right? And it took a while, but I got him. And he's a better legendary commander to expertise than Minamoto, in my opinion. Now, if he's going to be a secondary, you might be thinking, well, is he worth 30 bucks as a secondary commander? Well, yeah. The reason for that is because, as we've already established, this first skill is insanely good. He is at 5511, in my opinion, probably on par or slightly better than the epic commanders that care about cavalry. But the important thing about Rise of Kingdoms, the one thing to keep in mind, is that no commander stands alone. They're always in pairs if you're fighting properly. So you can't just say, is he good? Because you have to compare him to everything else. So if you get him to 5511 and use him as a secondary, you can use him as a secondary with Pelagius, who also has the skill tree, and also cavalry, and they're going to be doing a lot of skill damage, which is great. Same thing with Bybars. Bybars has a fan-shaped skill attack here, which is pretty cool. And what this does for you with Minamoto is it actually enables you as a low pay-to-play player to have 2 full cavalry marches out on the field, right? Because let's say you don't buy Minamoto and you're not spending enough money to make Cao Cao useful or any other legendary cavalry commander, then you're stuck with 3 cavalry commanders, which is not enough to make 2 sets of 2, right? Because we have Pelagius and we have Belisarius and we also have Bybars. So one of those 3 is going to be alone, and you'll be forced to pair them with some other universal commander, which, you know, you could do. You could pair Pelagius with Osman the First and focus on skill damage, or you could pair them with, I don't know, Boudicca for the same thing and get some debuffs in or something like that, or whatever. But these universal epics like Boudicca and Osman, I don't think are as good as Minamoto in a full cavalry march because of this 20% plus the 10% attack march speed. Sorry, I think what getting Minamoto at 5511 does is actually gives you the ability to have 2 moderately effective full cavalry armies on the field at once, whereas if you don't have him, you've got to kind of fill in that slot with something else. So that's my opinion. Whether or not you should invest in Minamoto, first of all, comes down to how much you're willing to spend. Second of all, comes down to how old is your kingdom, and from there you can make a decision. If you're gonna spend a lot in the game and the kingdom is early, max Minamoto. If you're gonna spend a little on the game and the kingdom is early, I would say it's probably worth getting Minamoto to 5511. If you've already gotten him to like 1111, probably don't buy him, just because you don't know where those are going to go, and if they all go in like these last 2, then he's going to be useless anyway. So that's a side note. If your kingdom is old and you are interested in spending a lot of money, I would say skip Minamoto, because you're probably not going to use him. If you're going to spend a lot of money, you'll have other options. Because you have an older kingdom, you'll probably be able to get Attila, Takeda, Genghis Khan, whatever. So yeah, you could just focus on them. If you're going to spend a lot, then, you know, that's, if that's in your price range, just go for them. And finally, if your kingdom is kind of past the 6 month mark and you are interested in spending a little bit of money, you haven't bought Minamoto yet, you know, maybe he's worth the 5511. I know that's a kind of an iffy statement, but it's up to you based on what other commanders do you have, right? If your kingdom is 9 months old and you don't spend that much money, but you've somehow expertise Cao Cao, then, you know, probably don't get him, right? But if not, then you're looking at basically adding another epic cavalry commander, but even a little bit better than that, right? I would say he's like, if epic tier commanders are tier four and legendary commanders are tier five, I would say Minamoto is a tier 4.5 commander. I would put him above epics, but below legendaries. And that's kind of where he sits. Guys, I hope this video was useful for you. Hopefully this answers your questions on whether or not you should purchase Minamoto. Hopefully I've laid out enough scenarios in this video for you to be like, okay, that's the scenario I'm in, and this is what he recommends. Hopefully I was able to help you guys. If you did find this video useful, drop a thumbs up on it. I would really, really appreciate that. Subscribe and turn on notifications for more content just like this. Comment down below if you have any more questions about Minamoto or cavalry commanders or Rising Kingdoms in general. Your comments are how I know what to make a video on next. So if there's a commander you want to ask questions about, or a civilization or anything like that, drop a comment down below and I'll be sure to consider it for my next video. And with that being said, guys, thank you so much for watching. This has been Omniarch. I will talk to you guys again soon. Peace.